My name is Captain Gus. I'm a fishing guide on Lake Norman, and I've been on and off the lake since its inception in 1963.
Wow.
The lake is big. It's over 34 miles long. It's got 520 miles of shoreline. And at its deepest point, 130 feet.
Oh, wow.
That's more than deep enough to support a monster of gigantic proportions. Way back when they just about formed the lake, there was some experimentation going on by some disenchanted biologists, and they actually were doing some of the very first experimentation with fish farming.
Okay.
So what they did is they built a little pond on the west side of the lake over here in Denver, North Carolina, and they crossed a Arkansas blue catfish with a Wyoming buffalo carp. And they put them in the lake, and then they fed them some chickens laced with steroids. And the fish grew immediately. A catfish tastes good. A carp grows fast. And when they added the steroids, they had a winning combination.
Wow.
Things were going great until the dam broke in the pond. The fish swam out of the pond and into Lake Norman.
Okay.
Years went by. Because this was a clandestine operation, nobody knew about this little escape.
Right.
And as years passed, some of the fish survived. They got bigger and bigger and bigger. They got gigantic. They got enormous in size. Way up the lake above I-40 is the upper dam. It's called Lookout Shoals. One day, somebody was looking down at the dam into the water, and they noticed this gigantic something. It looked a little bit like a carp. It looked a little bit like a catfish. It looked a lot like a monster.
How big was this thing?
It was enormous. It was probably bigger than a stretch limousine.
Oh, God.
So he actually reported it at one point as being bigger than a submarine, but then that was kind of an exaggeration.
Yeah, right.
I can't imagine anything being that big. Anyway, years went by. Nobody heard a whole lot about it, saw a lot about it, until the divers were working on the dam at Cowan Ford.
Mm-hmm.
And they're working down there doing whatever divers do to work on a dam, and all of a sudden, it gets dark. They look above them, and there's this gigantic shadow.
Wow.
They look up. It scares the heck out of them. They know it's something big. They don't know whether it's a fish. They don't know whether it's a monster. They don't know what it is. But they get so frightened, they get out of the water. They report it to their superiors. They're laughed at. They never return to the lake again, and they disappear from sight.
Mm-hmm.
It's not to say that there's something that's adding to the fire that causes fish to do certain things.
Mm-hmm.
I think more than the nuclear plant is the deep water down there. It's 130 foot at the dam. And that's perfect for a monster that size. I'm not sure how deep Loch Ness is. You might know. But certainly 130 feet deep is deep enough for a monster to feel safe. All right. Here's the other exciting thing about the monster. You know, we've been out there looking for them with sonar and fish finders and all this stuff, just like they have at Loch Ness.
Right.
And every time they think they get some kind of meaningful reading, it ends up being nothing. Well, here's what's different here. The lake has underground springs.
Okay.
And underground caverns and caves. And we think that one of these caverns or caves is big enough to support the monster in whatever group he's assimilated over the years. So when he hears that pinging noise from a sonar, and they can hear it, he can sense it in his body, I think he goes into this safe haven.
Okay.
So I doubt ever, unless they drain the lake, will we ever find the monster swimming under the water. We might end up finding it at night and seeing, getting some sightings. There's been sightings here. There's been sightings there. There's actually a website now called LakeNormanMonster.com that allows people to make monster sightings. It's kind of a place where you're not criticized for seeing a monster on the lake, kind of like seeing a flying saucer. If you see a flying saucer, they think you're crazy. If you see an alligator in Lake Norman, they think you're crazy. If you see a monster in Lake Norman, it's okay if you report it to the Lake Norman monster. But in any event, the latest and greatest thing that's happened with the monster is that he's still around.
Oh, wow.
And there's still sightings, particularly in the summertime, because he must like warmer water, and there's a lot more people out there.
Okay.
People ask me, Captain Gus, you're out there all the time. Have you seen the monster yourself? Can you verify that there's truly a monster out there? And that's the most important thing I think.
Right. And you've been over there in the lake a lot.
Yeah, I've been there forever. Now, here's what I tell you. I'm not sure. I think at times that I've seen him, and in other times I'm not sure. I think what we have to do is we have to continue to keep our eyes out and see what we see.
Well, thank you, Gus. Thank you for meeting up with me, and I hope we can see some pictures of this lake monster.